So what about that and this tax cut in the end? Let's say it does come to fruition. Is this all it's cracked up to be? The presidential historian, Game of Thorns author, among others, Doug Wheat. Doug, I have a slightly different view on this, and I know I'll hear from the people saying, never Trumper, globalist, et cetera. I think people are going to be disappointed in this. Individuals who will discover come next year or whenever it takes effect, if it takes effect, if it happens, and their net doesn't really move that much, and they don't see the commensurate run-up in stocks that they thought they would, that maybe all that was pre-factored in. But I think that this push for simplicity over just giving people a better net gain in their paycheck is going to come back to rue the day for Republicans. What do you say?
Boy, that could very well be the case. That's a reality. And you heard Mitch McConnell's recent comments. Wow. So something is going on here. They may, as you say, they may quickly pass this tax bill, and it may not be what Trump wants to stick his name to.
All right. Now, Roy Moore is one of the reasons why I suspect, in my opinion, I could be very wrong, they're moving so quickly. Obviously, that special election in Alabama is scheduled for December 12th. It is most likely, things being what they are now, that a divided Republican vote, even if he were to leave, he's still on the ballot. Even if they were writing candidates, it divides a Republican vote. So why risk that when you can try to get this all done with the Republican votes you have, the 52-48 advantage you have before then? What do you think of that?
Yeah, I think that's very shrewd analysis, and that's very likely. I have a source. I hesitate to share it because I haven't confirmed it yet. But he's a source that very prominent in the Republican establishment, who tells me that the Republican establishment themselves popped this whole Judge Moore thing. So we do have this unusual moment in history. You can't quite compare this to Reagan or other presidents and pushing a clean tax cut bill or any kind of legislation, because you have this whole new metamorphosis of the Republican Party. It's almost like the Whigs becoming the Republicans. You have a change in the Democrat Party and the Republican Party. So if Trump gets his tax bill, he wins. If Trump doesn't get his tax bill, he wins, because he can go to his base and blame it on the rotten establishment, Democrat and Republican. So there's two things occurring parallel on the same track, and it makes for a confusing but fascinating time historically.
Do you think this stymies Steve Bannon and the, you know, the quest to get outside the box, renegade candidates, in your face populists, those who would take on the establishment, that people might just say, you know, go slow here. This is not the way we want to go.
Yes, and I think the president's conflicted about that, too. Obviously, you can see in his comments, because if he really wanted to pass this tax bill, I think he could do it. He says nice things about Putin. He could say nice things about McConnell. So he could do it, I believe, if he really wanted it.
What do you think the effect of all of this will be? You're a great historian, and you know some of our most historic cuts have been those that have been across the board, whether going back to JFK, even though they took fruition in LBJ's administration, or Ronald Reagan's cuts, or George Bush Jr.'s two cuts, that they had an impact because they were across the board. Now, different folks have different opinions. I'd just like to get yours, that this is not across the board. This is not nearly as big as those. What do you think?
Yeah, I like your initial gut reaction that you said at the top of this segment. I think there may be some disappointment. They may get this and then say, well, what did we get? But the interesting thing about Trump, if you study him and the private sector as well as in politics, is he revisits these things. He comes back. He starts a building project. If it doesn't work, he waits, and he comes back a few years later with different players. So he may not be done with tax, even if he gets this bill through.
But if, let's say he does, and he's facing a Democratic Congress after next year, or at least one of the houses, do you see that as a possibility?
Yes, that's a very real possibility. But as I said, the Democrat Party is transforming, too. It's not just
very
the Republican
true.
Party. The Democrat Party's going way to the left. We've never seen anything quite like this. We don't know where either party's going to end up. We know that the American public are fed up with the establishment. Trump is plugging into that, and Bernie Sanders is plugging into that.
Yeah, too early to tell how it all sorts out. Doug, thank you very much. Good seeing you again.
Thank you. Good to see you, too, Neil.